First of all, I want to thank everyone for coming out and sharing in this demonstration with us. We were expecting a few more people, but we're going to go over what we had. We're just happy that everyone's here in support of the Trayvon Martin's untimely death. Now, we have a few issues that we're going to discuss this morning. I'll start out with a general reason for the demonstration, and then Mr. Peters will follow up with other issues that are affecting our community. And we feel right now is a good opportunity for us, number one, to highlight things that affect us as African Americans, but also that are need to be addressed throughout this state and throughout this nation. So, good afternoon. First of all, my name is Reginald Weary, and I am the president of the St. Mary Parish chapter of NAACP. Now, the purpose of this demonstration today is to show our support for the Martin family on the day before the Florida grand jury is to convene on his untimely death. There is much speculation as to what happened on February 26, 2012 in Sanford, Florida, but the fact of the matter remains that another young black male lost his life. Now, if justice had prevailed in this situation, there would be no need for this demonstration. If you will allow me, I will touch on two issues in this case and also pose a few solutions to the problem. Now, before I get started, I would like to go over the mission statement for the NAACP. The mission statement for the National Association for the Advancement of Colored People is to ensure the political, educational, social, and economic equality of all rights of all persons and to eliminate racial hatred and racial discrimination. Now, the rights protect individuals from an unwarranted infringement by government and private organizations and ensure one's ability to participate in civil and political life without discrimination or repression. Rights also protect from discrimination on grounds such as gender, religion, race, sex, national origin, and also freedom of thought, speech, expression, religion, press, and movement. Civil rights were designed to guarantee equal protection under the law. Now, the Stand Your Ground law gives you many rights, but it does not give you the authority to stalk someone, kill them, and then plead self-defense. According to the law, you're allowed to use deadly force if you are in imminent danger of losing your life or receiving great bodily harm. The Stand Your Ground law also states that you must be acting lawfully. Now, last I checked, stalking is not a lawful act. Stalking refers to unwanted and obsessive attention behaviors related to persons and intimidation that may include following the victim in person and or monitoring them. So following someone, approaching them, after being told by the dispatcher not to do so, is a criminal offense. Now, let's eliminate race from the discussion for a minute. So regardless of color, you follow a suspicious person, confront them, a fight ensues, and you kill the person that you were told not to follow, and then plead self-defense. After doing so, you are not arrested, nothing happens to you for over a month. To this day, you are able to walk around freely with all the uncertainty surrounding this case and enjoy your rights to a fair trial and due process. But my question is, what happened to Trayvon's rights to stand his ground? This is the issue that we are here to address. Now, this is the problem that we're faced with. Now I have a few solutions for you. Number one, the Stand Your Ground law that has protected Zimmerman from being arrested has flaws. We must get with our congresspeople and have this law amended or repealed. This law is legal in over 20 states across the U.S., including Louisiana. Now, I have no law degree, spent no time in the academy, and am able to find flaws in this case. Yet, we have a veteran police officer in this parish saying to research the facts and that this was a good shooter. With this, I do have a problem. The law in Louisiana is more lenient than it is in Florida. So I hope that there is no way someone in this state succumbs to the same pressures or the same mishap that Trayvon did. If nothing is done, this law will lead to more vigilante act crimes across the nation. Number two, the most powerful solution is to exercise your right to vote. Many of our forefathers fought for this right to be equal in this society and to have a voice. Your vote is your voice. In October, there was a major election throughout this parish, and many in the parish chose not to let their voice be heard, and subsequently, the turnout was one of the lowest in recent history. In order to repeal or amend the law, We must elect people that share our views, that listen to our voice. Elected officials tend to support the views of people that elected them. If they feel there's no threat for non-supporters, then they will not stand for the whole area, only those that elected them. With that in mind, we need to let our voice count. Not just for us, but for our kids and our future generations. Now, I'm not telling you who to vote for, but the crime, it is a crime for you not to vote at all. So with that, your vote does matter. Now the third thing, the third solution is we must unite in issues, on issues that affect our kids, the future of our race. So Mr. Peters will come up in a little bit and go over some more issues that affect the kids. But St. Mary Parish, you have no idea how strong your voice can be. We need to come together and let our voice be heard from the east end to the west end, from Generette to Amelia. Only then will the leaders of this parish take us serious. A people united cannot be defeated. Now in conclusion, if you look to your left, you will see a table set up to register to vote. At that same table, we also have applications for people that would like to join the NAACP. If you are not registered, please stop by and register. Not only that, if you are registered, by all means, get out and vote. Let your voice be heard. Also, we would love to have any of you, regardless of race, to join us in the fight against injustice across the nation. Please feel free to pick up an application and join the St. Mary Chapter NAACP as we continue to fight for equality and justice for all people of this parish. Thank you.